You know how I say there's always something going on. This morning, a truckload of wood shavings from Canada is here.
So I line these guys up. They're gonna unload it while I go load.
Two semis, let's get going. Loaded a step deck, but my camera froze, so I didn't get to show you any of that. But I do have another GoPro mounted on the outside of the squeeze filming this, and now I am picking this trailer up off of this other set of trailers. All right, it's off the trailer. He drives forward. I give him the signal. It's always a guessing game. Right there. Too far. Come back just a hair. Just a little. Come back. Right there. We'll see. I always like to see how well I guess. Now we let it back down so he can grab the tongue. He swings it around and we see how close I guessed. Oh, it's gonna be close. I got a little play left in the side shift. And yes, we're good. It's always awesome to get it the first time. It doesn't always work. All right, time to start loading him. Let's see if we can do this with one hand. Neutral. Open him up. Back up. This is too difficult. I'm setting you down. So they're calling for rain starting tomorrow. So at the moment, trucks are all loaded. I'm gonna start cleaning up. I've already put a few things away. When I say clean up, I'm out here at the barn where I load the semis, and there's always little short stacks sitting around from loading step decks or dry vans. So I'm just gonna drive around, pick them up, and put them away under the shade. That's what away is. I've got a barn where the hay is sticking half out. If you look, there's the edge of the barn and there's the hay. It hasn't really bothered me that much just because we haven't had any rain. Well, now we have some rain and I have other space in barns, so I'm gonna go ahead and move all that hay. It's gonna keep water from getting on top, which is good. However, it's going to open up some green hay, which is now going to get yellow. But I would rather let some green hay get yellow than water get on top. So that's what we're going to do now. Here's a great opportunity to show you different qualities of hay. This hay is green, so it makes it easy to show. If you look, this hay is showing a lot of stem in it. However, it also has a lot of leaf in it. You can really see the leaf pattern in the sides of it as well. Up here you see there's still a lot of leaf. It's a good horse feed. However, look at this bale. It's real leafy, but it still has a lot of stem. You can see it in these yellow bales as well. The stem, but the leaf. Stems, leafy. Now this is my number two quality because of the stems. This is June hay. You can see it's not bad. It's very leafy, but it's showing a lot of stem. Showing a lot of stem gets it a number two quality. Some of that was a pretty good number two. Some of it was a little more rough. Let's go see some number one. So we're up under a barn where this number one is stored. It's hard to see because of the yellowness, but this has a lot more leaf to it. A lot less stem shows. That's too dark back there. It's getting worse. Let's go out where it's sunnier. Here we go, the squeeze rubbed up against it. It's just a lot more leaf. I even have to zoom in, get a lot closer for you to see it, because yeah, there's stem, but it doesn't show as much as that other stack was. This stuff was actually baled in July, which July is the beginning of our monsoon season when moisture sets in. Now, moisture to us is like 15, 25%. We're dying. A lot of you guys watching, that's miserable. Or that's you would rather it be 15, 20%. 15, 20% for us is miserable. But just trying to, I wish this was green, you could see it better, but it's got a lot of leaf and the stem size is a lot smaller. I'll pull a couple of these stems out and we'll walk over and compare stem sizes. Comparing stem size, that sounds bad, doesn't it? I guess you could say us farmers compare stem size. Just kidding, but I'm not kidding. Okay, I'm back to the number two. If you look, this stuff is much smaller than that stuff. It's hard to tell, but I promise you it is. See the size difference? This stuff's just big and thicker. So there's number one and number two. I've got another barn where it splits half of its number two and half of its number one. Let's go look at it real quick. Ooh, I need to go mark that green stuff. I'm feeding 50 head for a guy. He brought his own feed because I don't have enough lower quality feed for cows. So I gotta get that marked so my employees know that is what we feed his cattle. Number one, number two. This is just dry. Not much leaf in there at all. Even looking through the sides, it's not very leafy. Number one, leaves. Leaves. Yeah, there's some stem, but there's a lot of leaf. Number one, number two. Number one, look at all this leaf content. Over here, a lot of stems. So there's another good description of the difference between the two. But something I'm always keeping an eye out for are our weedy stacks. This is awesome, small stemmed, green leafy hay. However, boom, look at that. That's in it. Ugh, weeds. Weeds. More weeds. If I sent that to a customer 1,000 miles away, he's not gonna be very happy. So I've gotta separate it. Oh, look at that. Oh my gosh. It's disgusting. So when I'm unloading trucks, looking at them in the field, I'm keeping an eye out for weedy stacks. Gotta keep them separated. Cannot send them to a customer, especially one that's 1,000 miles away. This kind of hay I have a hard time grading. It's right on the edge. Yes, it's green. It just came out of the field. It's just a hair dry, but then they've got some bales with some good leaf in it. Pretty good leaf, dry again. So I don't know. This kind of hay always is the hardest to judge, but whatever. Whatever. Want to see something funny? My other squeeze driver, this must have been in March. He drew a picture of a bat and then wrote, "Don't eat" on it. I'm sure you guys can figure that out. Here's a good, what like the number 3 looks like. It is just pure stems. If you cut that open, it will not flake at all. If you're not a farmer or a horse person and you're wondering what a flake is every time the plunger goes into the chamber, the chute, and pushes the hay in. Whoom, that's one flake, another flake, another flake, another flake. That's flake. This stuff will not flake. It's just poof. Yuck. Number 3. That's why it is sitting out on the edge underneath an eave, because I'm not going to waste barn space on the inside of keeping that dry powdery stuff all green. Oh, being a hay farm is easy. There's nothing to it. Yeah, it's all the same. Yeah, no, it's not the same at all. It's a lot of work. Look at those ants. I just pissed them off. Yes. One of my pet peeves. Oh, I got a bunch of yellow hay on the truck. Look it. It doesn't matter. It's like an inch thick or less than an inch thick. It's just from the sun. Yes, I get lots of complaints about yellow hay. Watch this. Look, look. Look, ready? Oh my gosh, it's green. Another pet peeve, I've even had to fire a customer over this one. I get a phone call that the hay doesn't look good. It's all the way in like East Texas or was it Oklahoma? I don't remember. But he's saying it looks terrible. There's no leaf on it. He doesn't like it. He's throwing a fit. I'm like, well, okay, sir, I loaded it myself. I know it looked good when it went on the truck. Have you cut a bale open yet to see what it looks like inside the bale? Nope, he did not. Okay, where's the hay? Well, it's still on the truck. So it's still on the truck. You're looking at it on the side of the truck. Yes, I'm looking at it while it's sitting on the truck. Do you realize what that hay just went through to get to where you are? It just rode on the side of a semi over 1,000 miles, and they put big tarps on the hay to keep rain from hitting it. You know what those tarps do going 80 miles an hour down the road? They flap around. Even if there wasn't a tarp on it, the wind is blowing by it going 80 miles an hour. You know what the wind does to leaves on the side of a stack of hay on a truck going 80 miles an hour for 1,000 miles? It knocks a leaf off. So yeah, he did that to me twice. I told him, call me back after you pull the hay off the truck, cut a bale open. Of course he doesn't call me back. So I finally call him, and of course it's really nice hay. And I think the third time I decided it was time to find a new customer. So yeah, pet peeves, there's a lot of them. I think people imagine a hay farm is much like a canned food or soda factory. We walk in and there's a big green button. We just hit on and it goes, and it makes every bale exactly the same every single time. We're fighting weather, so rain, wind, sun, that's one thing. Two, part of the sun, the heat, is it hot, is it cool, whatever, but that's every other farmer. I mean, you guys all understand if you're a farmer. Three, it's a dirt field. I can't control how that dirt grows. We add fertilizers, we try to kill weeds, but weeds pop up. Irrigation brings in seeds from other fields, it happens. Four, I've got employees that sometimes, when you're baling thousands of acres throughout the year, thousands and thousands of bales, not every one of them's gonna be perfect. Five, the equipment. Sometimes a baler or a scale on a baler isn't correct. It says it's making a 92 pound bale, and really it's making a 102 pound bale. So there's a lot of different reasons a bale doesn't come out perfect every time. No, it's not science, it's an art. Okay, I think these are all I need to put away. That Sudan grass saved for cows. I don't know, I guess I should put it away. If it gets rained on and sits in mud, it'll just get even worse. Okay, back to the squeeze. That's more stuff saved for those cows. I gotta get that painted too. Don't let me forget to paint that. We'll be right back.